Today, we're gonna talk about pads. How to clean your pads, when you should dispose of your pads, dirty pads, hybrid pads, foam pads, wool pads. Today's talk is all about pads. Hi guys, Michael here with Marine Detail Supply. And today, we're gonna teach you how to clean pads. I get questions all the time about what do I use to clean my pad? Soap, water, degreaser, bleach, all sorts of different types of things. Today we have wool pads, foam hybrid pads, and today we're gonna teach you how to clean these pads. So the first thing you're gonna wanna do with all your pads, these are all pretty dirty. This one's not as dirty. You can see when a foam pad gets really dirty, this one's a little older, it's a force pad, that it gets kind of clogged up, dry, and stiff. There's this one you can kind of squish down a little bit more because it's not clogged up with compound. So for these, to spray them down with some Simple Clean from Stark Yacht Care. It's an all-purpose cleaner, works really well as a degreaser. Spray all these foam pads down. And then I'm gonna drop them in the bucket. I like to let my foam pad soak a little bit. In this bucket over here, I've got Dawn dish soap and Simple Clean mixed together in a bucket. And I let the pads sit in there for a couple hours, sometimes not as long. But this is for like a deeper clean. Especially if you've got some wool pads that are super nasty. These ones aren't so nasty. This one's pretty bad. But what you want to look for when you're trying to decide if you should throw your pad away, this pad is fairly new. I think I've used it only one time, but I use it on a colored hull, so obviously there's a bunch of black staining on it. The black staining isn't gonna come all the way out, ever, never, unless you bleach them, which is just gonna wear the pad out quicker. But what you wanna look for is the fluffiness and the strands, the wolf strands here. See how I still got a lot of fluff left, and the strands are, you know, fairly new still, whereas get an old pad, this one's pretty worn out. You can see the fibers are starting to combine together. And a lot of the wool kind of gets flattened out where it's not fluffy anymore. So when you put compound on it, it's just moving it around. It's not really cutting like it should. This is a great example of a foam hybrid pad that's met its death. It's at the end of the road. See how the hairs are starting to become thicker, whereas these are still fine fibers. This pad's only been used a little bit. When they get like this, toss them out. People are like, well, why do I have to throw them out so often? Well, I mean, if you're doing a 30-foot boat or 25-foot boat and you use it on the entire boat, I mean, it's an $11 pad and it got you done the whole boat. So I think that's pretty good. So we'll spray all these down, throw them all in the bucket. All right, once you got all your pads in the bucket, you can go ahead and give them a nice soak, scrub them around. If the pads are really bad, I'll use a brush. I've got a drill brush over here. Just kind of trying to hold this camera and scrub it around, but almost like cleaning carpet. when you're brushing the pad, you want to brush it in kind of the same direction. Get all the hairs nice and straightened out. And then you can flip it over and do the same thing on that side. You will get a lot of hairs that you pull out with the brush. Especially if it's a newer pad. I'm sure everybody knows when you open a fresh wool pad, you look like a woolly mammoth after you're done with it. But this will take a lot of those loose fibers out of the pad. So once you got your pad soaked up in that solution for a good amount of time, whether it's a half an hour, 2 hours, overnight, whatever you want to do, the longer you soak them, the easier the compound and oils are all going to come out. Fill up another bucket of water, and then you want to transfer the pads into this bucket and rinse them really good. After you get them all in the bucket, kind of rinse them out, and you can start taking them out. When you take them out of the bucket, kind of want to squeegee them out, because we're going to put this pad on a rotary and spin it out. And the more water you leave, the more water this is going to shoot out everywhere. So just kind of squeegee, see how clean that pad came. What I've noticed is that the wool pads, they'll last a little longer, especially if you buy Lake Countries. I've used Buff and Shine and Lake Country, and I feel like Lake Country lasts a little bit longer. I use the 8-inch by 2-inch nap. They also got a 8-inch by or 7.5-inch by 1.5-inch nap. I like the 2s though. That one came out nice too. So yeah, it's still fluffy. This pad is pretty much done over here. I just wanted to clean it, show you the difference. You can see the backing plate in this one. And just like feeling it, it's not fluffy like this one. See how it's matted? Fibers aren't really as individual anymore. This pad is probably its last leg. Remember that really bad clogged up pad we had from that force pad? That's clean, like perfectly clean. So these foam hybrid pads are tricky because I feel like they get one, you get one wash out of them and that's it, because after that, they're just never the same. I mean, they start to get, the fibers start to stick together and become thicker. So these guys are not gonna get a whole lot of reuses out of them, but at least if you can get one. What also works really well when you're cleaning these, instead of using a pad spur, use, if you've got air, you can blow them out with air, which helps. A lot. Okay, so after you've got them all washed, you'll grab a rotary. This one is by Flex. And go ahead and put your pad on. Once you got your pad on, turn it down to a 1, lowest speed, and then give it a spin. Once you do that initial spin, then you can turn it up to 6 and let that spin for about a minute or so. Get a lot of excess water out. And then they won't be fully dry, but they'll be dry enough where if you need to use them in an hour or two,
sit them out in the sun while you're outside and you're good to go.
All right, guys, so that's it. Showed you how to clean pads today using Dawn dish soap, Simple Clean, and a wheel brush. Now we've got fresh pads spun out and ready to roll. Remember, hit that subscribe button, give it a like. I'm Michael with Marine Detail Supply. See you in the next video.